Love is a wonderful feeling, and everyone can feel it sincerely and wholeheartedly. But for some reason, not every person is able to open his heart for it. The depth and the strength of love depends on the readiness of people to let this feeling to be in their mind. Betrayal encroaches love with an aggressive and tactless interference in relationships between a man and a woman. It could either happen or just threaten the ability of this forthcoming. At this point, the situation depends a lot on the strength of love. The stronger feelings, the more painful betrayal hits. A really interesting thing is that it can either break off relationships or increase sensitivity between those who are in love with each other. AshleyMadison.com, the worldwide dating website, announced the arrival to the Ukrainian market today, which helps married people to find a consolation, making their life easier. Ukraine is 47th country that joins the prestigious Club of States, which has an access to anonymous dating site. We had an opportunity to communicate with CEO of the website Ashley Madison, Noel Biderman, on the Mediterranean coast. Mr. Noel said that he decided to create a website when he read an article which said that at least 30% of people registered on dated sites are married, but they tell they are single in order to find a lover.
Can you just introduce your company, your site, Ashley Madison?
So yeah, I'm Noel Biederman, the founder and CEO of AshleyMadison.com. And Ashley Madison is a dating site with a very unique twist. It's for people who are already in relationships. It's now in 48 countries, 36.5 million users, and is the second largest dating service in the world.
How old is the project?
So we started Ashley Madison in 2002, actually the day before Valentine's Day of 2002, which we call Mistress Day in our offices. And so it's been around for 13 years, and that almost makes us the granddaddy of internet websites.
Can you say what is exactly Ashley Madison, the true, the real person there or not?
Is Ashley Madison is the place that helps you find a like-minded person, someone just like you looking for the same thing. And also helps you keep it a secret. We know that almost all of our members are here trying to keep this from their spouses and partners. And so we built discreet technology that helps keep your messaging, your photos, even when you finish with your service, all a big secret.
Can we know more details about Nick?
Sure, so from the moment you sign up to Ashley Madison, it's anonymous. We're not seeking your name. You know, on the next level, it's all about private photos, under lock and key, disposable, masks so that you can't identify the person. Even our chat room is built as a fantasy so that you can chat in real time in a virtual coffee shop, a virtual beach at sunset, a virtual hotel room. I think even the way you delete your profile on Ashley Madison is different than anywhere else on the web. We won't just turn off your profile, we'll go back in time, take back all those messages you sent, all those photos you shared, make it like you were a ghost, like you never even existed. And last and maybe most important, we never bill you under Ashley Madison. You would never know that it was us charging your credit card.
Do you have any statistic that people meet each other in real life?
Yeah, we have polled about 150,000 members in the last year alone, and it turns out about 98% of the time they meet in real life. Of that, about another 80% end up having an intimate encounter. Now, we didn't ask what equaled an intimate encounter. I don't know if that's kissing, making love, other aspects of sexuality, but it turns out a huge percentage of people come to meet, and out of that, a very large percentage get into some form of intimacy.
How to get in and how much to pay?
It's free to join. You know, it's free for anyone to build a profile and say who they are and what they're looking for. Where the cost comes in is to communicate with one another. And so for approximately, $29, you would get the chance, I don't know what that is in rubles exactly, to communicate with another 20 different members, unique members. And so what we charge for is that initial communication. Thereafter, it's free.
Do you have statistic how many percent men and how many percent women goes in?
That's a great question, and this is an important answer to it, which is in every country we've launched in, despite being a female-focused brand, we've seen more men than women join the service. But there's a big but, because we have hundreds of thousands of men on the service, 65 and older, who we affectionately call our Viagra generation, right? We have no corresponding female demographic. And so I think part of what you see is there's a lot of biology in play when it comes to something like an affair. And so I think you really have to take a look at two factors. Age, right, which is, let's take a look at people in their 30s, which also is going to impact, you know, a different social era. You know, my mom is going to behave differently than you, and the next generation will be behaving differently. And then I think you also have to look at urban. You have to look at big cities. You have to look at the woman who's willing to pick up and move to another city for a job opportunity, for a lover or a husband. Those kinds of people are a bit more risk tolerant. And so when we look at cities like Sydney, Australia, or Zurich, or Paris, or New York, or Toronto, in their 30s, we have just as many women as men. But as soon as we start aging it up into their 40s and 50s, the ratios begin to change.
Also, do you know any statistic? In what countries is Ashley Madison more popular?
So on a country basis, you know, Japan would be our most popular in terms of per capita usage and the fastest to 1 million. We got 1 million members in 9 months. It took almost 5 years in North America to get to that. And so I think you see certain trends, you know, Japan, Brazil, certain places, the adoption rate is very high. I think that also depends on the female adoption rate, right? The more women that come to the service, interestingly enough, more men come as well. And so if women struggle coming to the service, because maybe culturally it's a difficult area, Mexico is a good example of that, or Venezuela, there is still a bit of a machismo culture and a lack of equality in society. There's not a lot of female journalists or female business people, and so there's less willingness to risk their marriage because they don't have the financial security. Those areas lag behind. But for the most part, on a per capita basis, places like Australia do really well for us, Switzerland does really well for us, and Canada.
What do you think? What different between mentality, people in America, people in Europe, and people in Ukraine?
I think what we've seen so far in the difference between the Europeans and the Americans is that in Europe, I think nobody wants to be cheated on, right? Nobody wants to come home and find out that their partner was cheating. But I think the European sensibility is that if that does get discovered, there isn't an immediate reaction to, we should separate. There's kind of this discussion about, okay, this happens, why did this happen? There's a discussion about it. I think in America, there's a very strong knee-jerk reaction that leads you to believe someone has to walk out the door. And so that was a big distinguishing factor we saw. As well as in Europe, we had a lot more women joining the service in their 40s and even their early 50s. In America, Ashley Madison's a much more youthful, 30-driven service, so there was an age discrepancy. I don't know yet what will happen in the Ukraine. I don't know what will happen in Russia. It's going to be a unique experience for us too. What I think is going to be really relevant is that, just like other countries we've launched into, you know, we sign up 40,000 people every single day, 40,000, who self-publish what they're looking for. They send 1.2 million communications every single day. And so really quickly, we will be able to tell you who's using the service, why they're using the service, and who they're acting with, you know? But to speculate right now, I don't know. I don't know how people are gonna react differently. I just know that infidelity happens in the Ukraine like it does everywhere else on Earth, and that Ashley Madison's a better alternative to having an affair in the workplace.
How you can control the people, which is teenagers, let's say, they're not up to 21?
So every profile, every photo, any communication is moderated on our service, you know. It costs us millions of dollars a year, and we employ dozens and dozens of people. We have offices here, we're sitting in Cyprus today, we have offices in Toronto with language skills that control all that element. Do we catch everybody who might be a bad actor? Probably not. But if you spend credits against somebody who isn't legitimate in the community, it's automatically refunded. And we also have really smart algorithms. You know, when you run a service as long as we have for 13 years, you tend to understand typical behavior, which is a married woman signs up, she looks around, she reads some profiles, she reads her emails, maybe she uploads a private photo, and then she rarely ever publishes a public photo and sends off 27 emails in the first 10 minutes. That's somebody not behaving properly, and so the algorithm would catch that and never deliver the emails. And as well, you know, communications on our service cost money, and so if you don't have a credit card, there is no way to create communication. So we think that between all of those factors, our human intervention, our algorithms, and the economics that this costs something to use, catches almost all that misbehavior.
What you are planning in the future?
I started this journey 13 years ago, never could have imagined being here, having a conversation with somebody like you, launching it into the Ukraine, right? But the journey's not over. There are still so many places on Earth that I think would benefit from Ashley Madison. And so I think I'll continue to do that. You know, retirement isn't for me. I'm an energetic CEO and I still have more of the world to conquer. And I help, in my mind anyways, people find happiness through Ashley Madison. So I'm going to continue with the journey.
Family is a small state with its borders, and it is the choice of its members to violate them or not.
Wait to decide. There's nothing that I